Raspberry Pi, as you can see, I have put a case to it, and I'm going to connect it with the speaker and the power port over here. And I'm going to connect two USB receivers for my mouse and keyboard. I'm going to switch on the power and I'm going to connect it to the screen. So it's on, and as you can see, the Raspberry Pi is booting up. And here you go, it's done. Well, before getting into the code, there are a couple of prerequisites that needs to be installed. One is Chatterbot. Chatterbot is the algorithm that is going to be used by this chatbot, and so it could be installed by using the command sudo pip install chatterbot. And the second one is eSpeak. eSpeak is the text to speech generation engine, and it is going to give us a better conversational experience. So it could be installed by sudo apt get install eSpeak. After both of these are installed in your Raspberry Pi, you can go ahead and start to code. One other thing that I missed to mention is that we need to download Chatterbot Corpus. You can search for download Chatterbot Corpus in Google, and you'll get the first link with a GitHub. So you can just use the clone or download option and download that files into your PC. For this part of the demo, I have just used a PC because I have not yet installed a good screen capture software in my Raspberry Pi. So all you need to do is to do the same thing in your Raspberry Pi. And one thing that you need to notice that the path of the data where this corpus is stored. Actually, this corpus data would be used by the chatbot algorithm to get trained. And this is going to be the initial training. And subsequently, once you are going to interact with your chatbot, it would learn more from your interactions. And if you see here, this is stored in the chatbot corpus master, chatbot data English, and there are a set of files within that. This is exactly going to be the same set of files that is going to be used by our code. And if you can just open and see one of the files, there will be some standard question and answers that the chatbot will be initially getting trained on. You can also just add one more file in the same format, YML format, and get that trained in anything else that you need. Now it's time to get into code. I have opened the Python 2.7 IDLE editor, and we're going to do our coding into two pieces. The first part is going to be used for training the chatbot, and the second part is going to be used to converse with the chatbot. So this is going to be the first part where it is going to be used for training the chatbot. I'm importing the necessary files from chatbot, import chatbot from chatbot.train, trainers, import list trainers, and import OS. And then I'm creating the instance of the chatbot with the name bot. And here I am going to read the files that we have stored in the path of chatterbot corpus. Here you need to just ensure that you are giving the exact path up to the end of the data folder where you have stored the data. And after the data, you just make sure that you're giving a forward slash so that the program works correctly. And this command is all about reading the data from the folder and using that to train the chatbot. Once you're done with the code, you can save it as chatbot_train.py. Then run the code. It it's throwing up some error. I think it is because of a spelling mistake in this line. I am going to correct it. Instead of this, I am going to just correct it as read lines. And then I am just running again, and you can see that the process is running and it's getting trained with the chatbot corpus data that we have provided. I have just provided the code in the link below in the description. So if you want to refer that, you can refer that directly. This is the second part of our code, which is used to converse with the chatbot. I am importing the same libraries that I had imported for the chatbot underscore train algorithm, and I am creating the instance of the chatbot with the name bot. One interesting thing that we are going to see here is to use some logical adapters. Logic adapters are nothing but the code that can be used to control the conversation from the chatbot. Here I am using a logical adapter called best match adapter, which essentially gives the best output with highest level of confidence from the chatbot. And I am going to use one more logical adapter called low confidence adapter, which means that if the level of confidence is less than 65% here as coded, it would give a default response, something like I'm sorry but I'm not able to understand. I'm just making sure that the code indentation is set at the right place. I think I need to delete that curve. So here comes the main code. I'm going to assign the raw input that I'm going to type as a message. It should be message equal to raw underscore input. It should not be message minus, but it should be message equal to. And then I am going to stop off this conversation if my message is by. So as long as the message is not by, then it invokes the chatbot and gets the output from it. So if the message is not equal to by, then I am asking the eSpeak test to speak speech algorithm to read out the message that whatever I am typing. And then I'm going to store the reply from the chatbot in a variable name called reply, and that is going to be with the function get underscore response. And once I get the reply from the chatbot, I'm going to just use that piece of line, the next piece of line, for formatting the reply to remove unnecessary characters. And then I'm going to print the reply back to the console. And then I'm going to use eSpeak to read out the reply. Here it is going to be a little bit different from the line above, because this line of eSpeak is going to invoke a female voice, and the earlier line of eSpeak is going to invoke a male voice. There's a bigger documentation on eSpeak that I will also post it along with the description of the link. So after that is done, if the message is going to be by, then I'm also asking the chatbot to print the same message as by, and then I'm coming out of the loop. I'm going to save this as chatbot.py. And then I'm going to run the program. So for this code as well, I have put the link for this code in the description below. You can refer the link directly if you want. Here is the outcome of the program. It's asking message from me on what is going to be my message to the chatbot.
What are your interests?
I'm interested in all kinds of things. We can talk about anything.
I'm typing my next question. Which language?
Which language are you written?
Python.
Do you drink?
My brain does not require any beverages.
What is AI?
Artificial intelligence is the branch of engineering and science devoted to constructing machines that think.
Who is your boss?
I like to think of myself as self-employed.
This is my last question. Do you know to cook pasta?
Do you know to cook pasta?
I'm sorry, but I do not understand.
It comes from the logic adapter that we have coded, and then there are more to it. Actually, there are more documentations. Here is the link of the chatterbot documentation. It is very good in the aspect it has lots of documentations and details around how this chatbot works, what are logic adapters, how it works, and things like that. So it also has details around how to train the chatbot, more details about the different kind of logic adapters, the best match adapter that we used in our code. It also has a time logic adapter where we can ask the questions about time. It has low confidence response adapter, and it also has the different parameters that the chatbot can be used with coding. And it also has frequently asked questions where some of the questions like how do I deploy my chatbot to the web has been answered. So it is a must for you to refer this link if you wanted to just build upon this chatbot to create something more interesting. And this is a link for each week where the logic around like different how to speak eSpeak, how to use eSpeak, and how to basically get different voices from the eSpeak, how to change the speed of the voice and things like that are mentioned. Well, I hope you like this video. I have provided the link of the code and other important link in the description below. If you like this video, you just please click the subscribe button below. Thank you very much.